a simple drive down Columbus Avenue in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, a glance to the Delaware River, your eyes will be drawn to a huge rusted piece of metal. The ship bears the likeness of an American flag that's been left in the sun too long. That piece of metal is a ship and is known as the SS United States. And this is her story. The year was 1916, and a man by the name of William Francis Gibbs was tired of working in real estate law and wanted to pursue a dream he had since reading news articles about the Titanic as a child, and that's design the biggest, fastest, and most luxurious ship in the world. William and his brother Fred befriended businessman J.P. Morgan, who financed his idea. But just as that dream was about to set sail, World War I began. One prime opportunity did come from the war, and that was two German ships being captured, first being the Vaterland, and the second, renamed by President Woodrow Wilson, the Leffian. Most of the 30s and 40s were spent working on armed service ships. 500 were designed during World War II. That was 70% of the U.S. fleet. By 1950, with financial support from Gibbs & Co. and 70 of the $74 million from the U.S. Navy, Gibbs' dream was underway. Construction of the newly named SS United States began early 1950. 3,100 workers were assigned with the task. The site was located in a dry dock in Newport News, Virginia, kept away from the public eye. The Titanic, the Queen Mary, and the Queen Elizabeth were all taken under consideration when constructing the largest ship the United States has ever seen. With 12 decks, 2,000 guests, and over 1,000 crew members, manpower was not an issue. Aluminum would be the key in the SS United States being the fastest ship to sail. In fact, the building of this ship was the most aluminum ever used in one single project. Safety was a major key in the build. The ship had almost no wood. So little, in fact, aluminum pianos were designed and almost built. At the end of the construction, it would be 990 feet long. That's 100 feet longer than the Titanic. The weight of her was 50,000 tons. With 70 million of the funding coming from the Navy, there was a bit of a catch. If the United States were to enter another world war, the ship would be there to answer the call. The Navy called her the Power of Survival. Being a 5-compartment ship, it could stay afloat with 80% of the ship flooded. 2,000 guests can turn into 15,000 troops, and you wouldn't require refill fuel until after 10,000 miles. She was also just narrow enough to fit through the Panama Canal with 2 feet on each side if needed. June 23rd, 1951, she launched. She was rumored to move as fast as 45 knots. That's 55 miles per hour during trials. The SS could also travel over 20 knots backwards. That's faster than the Titanic. On her maiden voyage, 3,016 people will be on that ship, compared to Titanic's 3,547 people. 1,024 were of third class. The SS offered 554 of the so-called tourist class. She was equipped with 25 restrooms, 395 staterooms, 14 first-class suites. They would offer 24/7 food and drink. On her first trip to Europe, she had 8,000 quarts of ice cream and over 500 pounds of caviar. On June 30th, 1952, 70,000 people gathered in New York, a line that stretched 14 blocks to see the ship. With rumors of an Atlantic Trans record in sight, on July 3, 1952, the SS United States set out her maiden voyage to Europe.
A new queen has been crowned. She is the liner United States, which holds a double Atlantic blue ribbon for speed. The $73 million luxury speedster makes the east-west crossing in 3 days and 12 hours from England to Ambrose Lightship, cutting 9 hours from the record held by the Queen Mary for 13 years. A royal welcome awaits the new monarch in New York Harbor as she steams to her berth. Sleek, streamlined, and trim, she completes the 2,900-mile run with an average of almost 40 land miles an hour, with a hint from her officers that she had plenty in reserve. President Franklin of the United States Lines and Grover Whalen congratulate Commodore Harry Manning, the skipper, on bringing back to America the Atlantic laurels for the first time in 100 years. A clean sweep for America's new Queen of the Seas.
Commodore John W. Anderson would serve as the ship's captain from 1952 to 1964. Before the ship, Anderson's claim to fame was he was the usual co-pilot of Amelia Earhart. He would be the ship's longest tenured captain. The SS would sail between 1952 and 1969, and she had her fair share of gusts. John Wayne, Grace Kelly, Charlton Heston, Gary Cooper, President Eisenhower, President Truman, President John F. Kennedy, a very young Bill Clinton, Frank Sinatra and Judy Garland, Jackie Gleason, Marlon Brando and Salvador Dali, Walt Disney, Marilyn Monroe. The SS United States was also in two movies, Disney's Bon Voyage and The French Connection with Gene Hackman and Roy Scheider. The late 1960s would not be kind to the ship. In 1967, William Francis Gibbs, the ship's designer, passed away. November 14, 1969, the ship would sail back to Newport, Virginia for her usual maintenance, but she would never sail again. With Transatlantic focusing more towards the air, and the armed forces as well, the SS was dehumidified and locked down and taken out of service by the Navy. In 1979, Mr. Harry Katz sought to buy the ship and turn it into a casino. In 1984, Richard Haley of Seattle bought the ship, but due to financial collapse, sold the interior furnishings and everything the ship had to offer to a restaurant, the Windmill Point in Nags Head, North Carolina. In 1992, it was bought by Fred Meyer, who had it shipped to Turkey in the Ukraine to have it completely stripped of asbestos. There was so much found on the ship, it was nicknamed the Ship of Death. From there, it will be shipped to Pier 82 in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, where it has remained since 1996. Since 1996, two major ship companies were in talks to purchase the ship. She faced being scrapped for metal well over a dozen times. A foundation was organized in 2010 to save, but in the meantime, just keep her afloat. Pier 82 charges $60,000 to have the vessel docked on their pier. The ship receives no state or federal funding. As recent as January 2018, an appeal was made to President Donald Trump to take action regarding the ship. Unfortunately, if the well runs dry on the foundation, they may not have a choice but to scrap her. An eerie ship, fading away in the sun, rusting away in the water. Built in a much simpler time. Built in a time where people put their hope in a symbol. In the shadow of loss and war, she reigned supreme of the seas and put the country first. She has a story to tell, but the only question is, will anybody listen? The next time you are driving down Columbus Avenue, tip your hat, cheers your water or coffee, and ask your people, hey, do you know anything about the SS United States?